Pink Hustle First Lady, subscribe to my YouTube channel. You dig it? She moving, yeah. Turn this up real quick, y'all. Turn up. She moving. He like the way she do it. She moving. He like the way she do it. She moving. He like the way she do it. Yeah. Grab the pole, slide down real quick. Make that nigga get his cash out real quick. Sliding down up on that dick. He got a couple ones to make it right on the shit.
Hustle First Lady coming at you with another YouTube video. I know I've been, you know, playing around and I ain't been on YouTube for a minute because a lot of stuff been going on and some blessings. But I'm hitting y'all with a video and it's my first time ever dating a Hiltonia nigga. And what he actually taught me is serious. And then, you know, it gives you some juicy details, you know, from sex to all of that. But make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hit that subscribe button below and also hit the bell so it will notify you when another YouTube video coming along. So make sure y'all do that. You feel me? So here we go. I had stopped by and gotten some bubbles. If y'all not familiar with Savannah, it's on Montgomery Street, right across from McDonald's. And I mean, for $10, you can have all of this. So good, y'all. I got my seasons, my butter, and my little crab season because I like putting it on myself. And this shit good as a fuck. So let's get started. I was in Statesboro, not doing too much. I also was talking to like different people, you know, about the city. I ain't had nobody to go with. So my cousin was like, you know, you can go with my baby mama or whatever. So me and her went. It was called The Spot. But it used to be packed, like real packed. It was Country Wayne Club. So that was called The Spot. So we went in there and, you know what I'm saying, like, chilling. I ain't gonna get into too much in details of what took place that night, cause like I think we fought that night. Like me and my cousin, baby mama, had fought a nigga in the club. Not in the club, but out, like at her house where everybody be meeting up at. So it was this dude. And he was just, like, you know, talking to us or whatever. He came. And I don't know, like, I always felt like God just sent him there to, like, tell us some shit that we really need to hear at the time. Because he was, like, talking to me. And he was, like, you know, he was, like, any nigga you get with, it have to be an upgrade. Like, you can't get with just any nigga. And he was, like, and he's like, to other niggas, you look intimidating. And he was like, but see, I'm a real nigga. And you don't intimidate me because real recognize real, this and third, blah, blah, blah. So we was just, you know, chopping it up or whatever. And I was like, you know what, I appreciate that shit. It made most sense, like, for real. A lot of shit he was saying, he knew, like, we weren't from around them. Like, we didn't know nobody. And he was just like, you know, I'm gonna make sure y'all straight. Y'all came in here and we all gonna leave out together. I'm gonna make sure y'all straight. And my brother's gonna make sure y'all straight. So I was like, okay, cool, whatever. So he told us to come down, like, cause it was like a little lounge area and then it was like the dance floor, right? So we walked down to the dance floor, and it was like a group of niggas, like no females, nothing. Like, when they was on the floor, you cannot, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was just their people in that group, you know? And the girls, you know, they were just standing there watching while they was in a group or whatever. So, and he was like, talking to other niggas, like, you know, watch out for them or whatever. This, that, and the third. So he came back to us and he was like, y'all straight. So we were like, okay, whatever. So we tiptoed, walking around, you know, scoping the scenery, getting drinks and shit like that. So I seen this one big tall nigga, right? He was with the group because he was in the circle and you could see him above everybody else. And he was red. And that's still my nigga to this motherfucking day. For real. And when I say that nigga ain't know me from a can of paint, that nigga rolled. For real. So, you know, I thought, nah, I didn't think nothing really because I knew there wasn't nothing to play with. So, but you know how sometimes, like, people actually let you fight and shit and, you know, just sit back and watch. I kept seeing him, you know, walk past us or whatever. So I was like, at the end of the night, when we went to the cars or whatever, I'm gonna tell y'all a bit of it. So I opened the door and a nigga get inside my car. So, bitch, I'm like,
oh my fucking God!
Why the fuck this man inside my car? So my cousin, baby mama, she was looking at me like, do you know this nigga? And I'm like, no, I don't fucking know this nigga. I don't know nobody out here like that. I was like, I don't know this man. So we was like, you know, talking to him, trying to see what the fuck he was trying. So he wouldn't get out of the car.
Hey, you wanna, hold on. You wanna fight?
And the same dude that was walking around watching us, making sure we were straight, he came over to the car. And he was like, y'all straight. But he also, y'all, oh, it's my shirt. But he was like, y'all straight. I was like, this nigga won't get out of our car. So, he was like, all right, we're gonna handle that like that. So, I'm like, okay. I'm looking crazy still. So, his brother, but in it, I just found out, like, they was really best friends. But his brother came and sat, like, I'm sitting in the driver's side, and he sat, like, you know, when you open up the door, that little spot right there? He sat right there, girl. And let me tell you, when he sat down, like, he pulled his gun out his, you know, his side and sat that shit on my lap. It wasn't no ordinary gun. It was, like, one of them guns that had, like, the clip on that shit. So, I was like, oh my fucking gosh. I'm gonna marry this nigga. That's what I said. My like, he was just talking to me. And he was like, so where you work at? I told him, you know, I travel back and forth from Savannah to Statesboro. But I live in Statesboro. So he was like, oh, for real? He was like, I work on Savannah too. And I be traveling back and forth. So I was like, okay. I'm like, all right, you know, ask him what he doing. And mind you, like, he was just, you know, looking, like, out as people was, you know, walking past or whatever. And I'm looking down while he got his arm, like, on my leg holding the gun. You know, I'm looking like, you know, like, this man, girl. So that nigga happened to look up at me. When I say, like, tattoos on his face. Follow me on Instagram. I posted a video, but I had to take it down because, like, who I'm talking to now, like, he was not feeling that shit. And he, like, put his foot down, child. Okay. Now, usually I don't listen, but he don't play no games, so I went ahead and hurried up and took that shit down because he don't play no games with me. So, and y'all, I do not listen. This is the crazy part, y'all. I do not listen. But when he was like, first he was like, did you make the video? And I was like, nah, I ain't make the video today, like this 4 years ago. He was like, you need to take that down, like for real. So I took it down. But God will see who he is. And some people, they know him. Some that might be watching this probably talk to him behind my back, but I don't give a fuck because I'm about to get to that store. I seen like the tattoos on his face and I was like, oh my God, like, boy, where you say you work at again? And at first I thought Nick was lying to me because I was like, this nigga got tattoos on his face, like, and they hired him with his tattoos on his face, like, he a truck driver. So I'm like, you know what I'm saying? But I instantly knew I was going to take him to see my mama. I instantly knew. I'm like, yeah, you're going to have to meet my mama. You're going to have to meet my grandma. You're just going to have to meet my family. I'm going to marry you.
Ah, Carissa, please.
Like, fine. So, make the long story short, I'm going to skip through that little fighting part because, you know, we end up fighting that night. Like, all of us end up fighting. Yeah, bitch, yeah, bitch. Call me Steve. Oh, I'm a wild boy. I'm a wild boy. I'm a wild boy. Fuck, but it was like us against somebody else. Cause the nigga wouldn't get from out the backseat of my car. So we ended up fighting. And, he was texting me that day, and he was like, am I going to see you tonight? And I was like, yeah, I mean, you can. So he was like, all right, cool. I work at, you know, such and such. And it was like literally 5 minutes up the road from where I worked at. So I was like, what is this coincidence? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, y'all, and the DJ, he was seeing all of this take play, and he kind of blowed at the same time. Because he was like, I'm the one that invited her, and she ain't even chilling with me. She's chilling with these niggas and this and third. But I ended up seeing him. So, yeah, I got him. And I'm a hood bitch, so I eat blue crabs and snow crabs, and I just decided to eat blue crabs. So, like, y'all, he was like, yeah, I stopped to the store, and I got us something to drink. So, I'm like, okay. He was like, so you drink? And I was like, yeah, I drink. He was like, what you drink, brown? Like that. Well, he was like, oh, okay. He was like, I got some shit called Paul. And I was like, Paul? He was like, yeah, but I call it. He was like, I call it Uncle Paul. Some shit he call it. Some shit. So I was like, all right, cool, whatever. So we talking, getting to know each other the whole way right there. And, like, his hand was on my thigh like, the whole time, child. And it was just making me so nervous because he was so fine. And I was like, oh, my God, like... You could tell I was young as the fuck because, like, anything could have happened. He could have been, you know what I'm saying? But I ain't give a fuck. I was like, this nigga fine as fuck. And period, it's the motherfucking weekend. Because it was like a Saturday because I went to the club that Friday. And I'm glad I did because if I didn't go, I wouldn't have seen him. So, I mean, he be there all the time. But it was just, like, perfect timing. It was, like, perfect timing. So... We went to my house, and we was, like, chilling, listening to music, and, like, he was making the drinks. And ever since then, I just started letting him make the drinks, because I'm telling you, like, this man make the best fucking drinks ever. Like, the best fucking drinks. Like, he know how to mix that shit and all. Me, I don't know, because I make some good-ass drinks, too. But I make the type of drinks to sneak up on you. Like, my drinks literally taste like juice. And then they be having like half alcohol in it, but you can't taste it. Cause I be doing like half and half. And like adding like all type of other shit in it, so you won't be able to taste it. So he ended up making the drinks or whatever, and they're like, we was drinking and talking, vibing. And this was around the time when Future had came out with his mixtape or whatever. So we was listening to that. And we was also listening to some Kevin Gates, because Kevin Gates was like that nigga. He's still that nigga, but like this was like when Kevin Gates, like everybody was listening to Kevin Gates at the time. So we was listening to music and shit like that, talking and child. And then like next thing you know, we was like kissing. And he the type, he's so fucking, he from Tiltonia, y'all. So if you want you a country nigga, you know, get you a nigga from like Statesboro, like Claxton. I don't know, cause they talking shit about Claxton. Glensville, Hiltonia, because they country, but listen, go home. They don't play no games out there. Them boys don't play no games. When I say they don't play no games, they don't play no games. So, like, we was kissing and stuff like that, and he was like, he's so aggressive, and it's like, it was like so new to me, because I wasn't like used to that shit, like, for real, I wasn't used to that shit. I was always the aggressor, or, you know what I'm saying, like, he was on some, like, might grab you by your throat and start kissing you, and I'm not talking about, like, kissing, like, if y'all seen that fucking video, this nigga would eat your whole face, like, for real. And I used to love that shit. But he used to throw me off every time he do it, because I was like, boy, stop playing. I would give you a sign. For real. So, one thing led to another. And child, I had this friend. And we used to always talk, like, we used to always talk about sex talk, because we all grown in here. So, we used to always have, like, the sex talk. So, I know I have some good pussy. Period. Like, I know I do. And, my friend, like, I had guy friends, too. And, like, they would tell me about my friend, like, they were like, you know, like, she got some good-ass head. So, I would ask her, you know, like, like, how do you make niggas act crazy? Like, don't get me wrong. Like, she don't go sucking niggas' dick just to suck their dick. Like, nah. But this one particular nigga was like, bro, she had the best head I ever had. So, I'm like, bitch, like, give me the 411 so I can know how to make a nigga act dumb. So, we was like, you know, drinking and stuff. And she showed, you know, with a beer bottle, showed us how it's done. And she was like, now, you can't do this trick on any random ass nigga. Like, she was like, only the one, like, you really, really like. And you look at him real special and shit. So, I was like, all right, cool. So, I wasn't trying on nobody. Like, nah. But him, bitch. Him. Bitch. Yeah, I'm sorry if I'm smacking, but I tried it on him time. And I mean, I would wait. And your body's hurting. And I knew, like, what spots to touch. All that, like. And he instantly just like, ugh. So I sat up, I was like, oh, okay. You ain't even, you know. You ain't even tried my pie. So, you know what I'm saying? So, he felt, you know, like a little punk. So, you know, he was like, hold on, y'all. Hold on. We got chill. So, I was like, okay, cool. So, we were still, like, talking and drinking and stuff like that. Talking and drinking. So, next thing you know, bitch, my panties was down. And I mean, when I say this boy ate every single part of me, every inch. And let me tell you, ain't too many niggas eat every inch and every part. This nigga wiped the bowl clean. So I'm like, okay, cool. I'm like, at this point, I want the dick. Like, period, poo. Because I need to show you what a BBW can do. Mine, he fuck with big girls. Like, he love big girls. Like, he really do. And he know how to handle big girls. Like, I didn't know that messing with him. Like, I'm just like, I'm going to turn him so bad to the point where he just ain't going to want to fuck with nothing but big girls at this point. Like, that was my mindset. I'm going to turn him out so bad. Like, he's just going to want to fuck with big girls. Like, he ain't even going to look at a skinny bitch. So, I had to show out for the big girls, right? So, I wouldn't even, because, see, I'm not lazy at all. I'm not lazy. So, I got up, started, right, moving my hips, right. And I think, what song was that? I can't remember what song was playing. Oh, Lucci. Was it Lucci? I think it was Lucci, because that's when Lucci had first came out, child. So I'm writing. And he like, oh shit. Like, then he like, to this point, he like, fuck no, like, you, I can't have you having me like this. So, girl, when I say this nigga was like, hold on real quick. So, he was like, I got up or whatever. When he was like, hold on real quick. I got up. And, you know, I'm a big girl. So, you know, when like, I got up, he flipped me. So, I'm like, you know, okay. And, like, girl, when I say, like, I was shocked because he went back to eating again. So, I'm like, hold on now. You can't be doing me like this. Like, I kept telling him, like, look, I got this crazy-ass spot. And I act stupid. Like, I be somehow, like, nah. I probably warn you, but then I won't even act crazy, so, you know what I'm saying? But this nigga made me act stupid, like, dumb stupid, like, crazy. So, he was just eating from the back, like, heavy, like, when I say, like, I was, like, to the point where I was, like, crying, because I was like, oh my god, this shit is so fucking good, like, what the fuck. So then he flies in from the back. I mean, like, and see, I already know my position. When you get it from the back, head down, ass up. So I'm like, head down, ass up. And he just tearing my ass up. And then he had his hand, like, around my neck, but, like, in the back of my neck. I mean, like, tearing my ass up. So I was like, fuck no, I'm a gangster. Like, So I turned and looked at him and just was throwing it back. So he was like, oh, shit. fuck. And he stopped and let me did my little thing. So I had to show out. Bitch, I be showing out for the big girls, okay? I be showing out. So I like, oh, fuck no, you're not about to have me like this. So I'm throwing it back, throwing it back, throwing it back. I was like, let me get on top again. So he looking at me like, bruh, you get on top, like, it's over with. Like, you know that, right? Like, if you get on top, it's over with. So I'm like, let me get on top. You know, let me just do my thing. So, because that was like my favorite anyway. Getting on top. Yeah, I got crabs all in my head. So that was like my favorite thing anyway, getting on top and riding. So I'm riding, I'm riding, I'm riding. And then I see him like, oh, like, you know, he was like moaning, like not moaning, but groaning at this point. So I'm like, okay, now you need to tell me when I need to get up so I can hop up. That nigga ain't tell me to get up. And that nigga ain't stop me either, because all I know is once I got up, it was nothing left. And I was like, what the fuck? So, like, that was kind of like a girl with a good old pussy. A female with good pussy could make a one-night stand into a relationship, period. So, after that, I was in a relationship, child. Like, I was in a relationship. He was mine. And that was it. So, we had, like, little situations here and there, like, one of my friends, like, she was like, he was just trying to talk to such and such. I'm like, first off, let's make this clear. You ain't telling me shit. Because around the time he was trying to talk to old girl, me and him just started talking. So, like, literally, he seen her, and then the next day he met me. You get what I'm saying? Like, fuck you telling me this shit for? Where he at now? So, I was like, did he fuck? Did they fuck? She was like, no, they ain't fuck. But he was trying to talk to this girl. Like, she was a mutual friend or whatever. So, I'm like, did he fuck her? Like, I'm gonna just get to her at some point. She was like, no. But, he was trying to talk to her. I was like, okay, me and him just started talking. So, whatever that situation is, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? They ain't got shit to do with me because that was before me when he was trying to talk to her. So she asked him, the girl asked him about me or whatnot. And he told her who I was to him. And ever since then, shit ain't been the same. Like, shit ain't been the same. But me, on the other hand, like, I wasn't giving a fuck because, like, this nigga ain't. He really wasn't doing shit. And it was like, it was sometimes like we had some hiccups and some boo-boos, but it was like the beginning, like, you know what I'm saying? We was at the beginning stage or whatever. And I think what kind of did it with our relationship was when I allowed a family member to come live with me. And, like, we didn't have no privacy. And he was like, he wasn't having that shit. He went to Miami to work. And he assured me, he was like, you know, like, I'm gonna come back this day and the third. But then motherfucker ain't never came back. So it basically, you know, me being me, I'm like, okay, fuck, like, you know, talking to, you know, friends or whatever, homeboys, and they like, bruh, you gotta think about it. We got a whole situation going on at your house, and it's just too much, you know what I'm saying? It's just too much for a person to deal with. So I'm like, okay. So I moved back down to Savannah. And at this point, he done came back. But it's all just happened in like a 2 month time frame of him leaving and me moving back to Savannah. So he came back and like we were just like, I mean, like nothing ever happened. I never questioned him about shit that was going on or what he was doing when he was gone, because my mama already told me how truck drivers is, you know, they got different bitches and different area codes. And like with him, he would tell me, so I never had to ask him like what the fuck going on, because he would tell me even if it hurt me. And I fuck with that because he wanted me to be real with him. You know, I think this was like the first time I ever lied to him. Cause he was like, and then another thing, like, he showed me like once a side of him that I know, like, if it ever got to a point and he was to see me with another dude, like, he'll lay that nigga out, like, for real. So I just, like, because it was, like, one particular time, like, my cousin, I don't know what the fuck my cousin was thinking, like, he had brought my ex to the house while he was there. And see, this is the crazy part about him, like, he don't show emotions. And I know he care for me. He say I love you and stuff like that. But actually showing like emotions, he don't show them. Cause he got like this hard like physique about him. So when the dude came, the dude was supposed to stay in the car. But the dude seen me and him get out the car and started walking to the apartment, which was my ex. My ex seen me and my new boo, you know, walking up the stairs or whatever. So my ex was trying to be funny and get out the car. And this nigga lit his cigarette, I tell y'all no lie. And me and my cousin, like, I'm standing behind him. And I'm looking at my cousin like, bro, like some shit about to go down and you playing. I done told you what this nigga already done told me. If he see this nigga, what he gonna do? And you bring this nigga to the house like you tempting him. That's when I think that's the reason why he really left. He would never tell me why. But he felt like, you know, he was in a situation and it could have went left so fast because how he is. He was just like, you know, I'm going to just go to Miami for a trip. And I'm going to work down there for a little while. And then I'm going to come back. So the dude got out the car, I guess, trying him or whatever. And then he was like asking my cousin for something. And my cousin, he was like knocking on the door. So the boy I'm telling y'all about, that's the truck driver. He lit his cigarette and pulled out his gun. And, like, he didn't have the clip in, so he was doing something, and then he put the clip back in the gun and was just holding the gun looking. And he was doing like this. So I'm like, fuck, like, oh my God. So I started banging on the door. And it seemed like it was taking my cousin baby mama forever to open up that motherfucking door. I don't know why, but it was just taking that bitch forever to open up that fucking door. But I was panicking. Because I'm like, bruh, like, this man said this shit. Like, I'm like, man, I had to tell my cousin, like, bruh, I just don't be dealing with any type of nigga. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, now, I had some lames. Like, don't get me wrong. I had some lames, but listen, this nigga was nothing to be played with. He was not, and he was just ready to lay a nigga out, for real. So I'm like, damn, like, my aunt gonna be mad. Cause it's like, at this point, this a family friend. And he basically, you know, been around, and I'm like, my nigga about to shoot his ass. Cause he wanna play and wanna be like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I still can pull up when I want to. I could still pull up when I want to. Cause me and her cousin cool. So, oh boy, I was trying to hit that. So finally, my cousin baby mama opened up the door, and we looking at her crazy. And like, I had, you know, told him to go in the room, and we just talking. And I don't think we did it that night, so we sure did. But he was just like, he didn't like that shit. And I was like, so why you pulled out the gun? Like, he was like, nah, I was just trying to, he was just trying to do something. I like, boy, no the fuck you was not. Like, I still to this day be like, boy, no the fuck you. No the fuck you was not. Like, even my own cousin said, like, bro was really about to pop that nigga, like, for real. He really was. So, that's how I knew, like, I couldn't play with him all type of ways. So, like, when he had asked me, because I guess my cousin had snitched on me or whatever, because he was mad because shit wasn't going his way. And him and his girlfriend was beefing and whatnot. He told the boy I had cheated with him from a nigga from Glenville. And, bitch, I did. Because he was cheating on me. That's the first time I ever did a tit for tat. Shit, no, it ain't, because I did it with my baby daddy. But I don't do shit like that, because that's, like, a dangerous game, but, like, mind y'all, this is within months of just, you know, like, us being on the outs, but somehow we will always get on good terms. So, my cousin had told him some bullshit like that, and I think that, like, when he was trying to talk to my homegirls, like, I think he was trying to get me back for that dumbass shit. My cousin trying to be petty. And he told my cousin, he was like, man, that's your cousin. He was like, I never seen it show my cousin. He was like, that shit not cool. And my cousin was like, man, she doing some fly shit. He was like, bruh, like, that should be between me and her. Like, you shouldn't do no shit like that. So, he came out blue one day. And, like, I don't know what the fuck I was doing. And he done been back for about 2 weeks. And he was like, babe, you cheated on me? And the way he said it, like, he was in disbelief because he was thinking about that shit.
I pull a U on you and you act like me.
A long minute. So I like, no. No, like, what the fuck? But like, alright. like that. But see, the reason why I said no, because I was scared, because like I was so scared, y'all. Because I wasn't. I don't know what he was capable of doing. So I told him no. And he left that shit alone. But it was always like in the back of his head, you know what I'm saying? My cousin told him some shit like that. And that kind of affected our relationship. I really did. That shit really did. So when I came here to Savannah, he came and seen about me or whatever. And we ended up drinking again. Like, that was our thing, cause man, I used to have like parties, house parties and shit. And I used to cook a lot. So I'd be like cooking while everybody drinking and stuff like that. And that night we had Hennessy, and y'all know what Hennessy do. And it was like that makeup, I miss you, and I know you cheated on me and I cheated on you. But that ain't gonna stop what the fuck we got going on, because we got a bond type shit. Like, that was the first thing I, like, when we was drinking or whatever, he was, like, kind of telling me in a way he was a dog. He was just like, you know, he talked to a lot of girls, and he was like, I don't put you in no predicament, because, babe, you crazy, and I'm crazy, and that shit, it just, you know what I'm saying? Because he'll act up, and I act up, and he ain't really want that, because that would have been a toxic relationship, but we was both calm in the relationship, like, real calm, like, we both was calm. I don't think we even ever had an argument. We never even had an argument. He never called me a bitch. Never disrespected me. And, but it was like, we wouldn't attack each other. Like, we would attack the person. Like, if I was to do something, like, he would attack that person. Like, if I was like to my ex trying to come back, like, he wasn't gonna play that shit. So and it was like vice versa. Like, I was dumb behind that nigga, like, for real. I used to cuss bitches out. I mean, like, bitch, it's me. And y'all hoes ain't fucking with me. That was my attitude or whatever. But, like, we was just, like, talking. And then, like, one of my friends was trying to fuck with him. And I don't know, like, how the fuck this shit came about. I think the girl asked him about me. And then he was like, babe, you know this girl? And I was like, yeah. And it was like one of my old school friends, right? And I was like, yeah, I know who she is. Like, we was like real close or whatever. And he was like, she been trying to fuck with me and shit. And I ain't, you know, if you know her, I ain't gonna do no shit like that. So I'm like, I'm instantly message the girl. Cause like, the crazy part, this is when I really realized, like, bitches used to watch me and hate on me so bad. But wasn't even my friend on Facebook. Alright, for real. So like, when I tag him and shit, bitches would, you know, go in his inbox and try to fuck with him. Because I'm like, how the fuck, this nigga from Hilltonia, now how the fuck y'all Savannah hoes know him? You know what I'm saying? Like, that shit just used to, like, y'all want to fuck me so bad. Like, if you cute, I might let you, you know? But you want my sloppy seconds? You know what I'm saying? Like, what is that? Like, girl, ain't no bitch fucking with me. Ain't gonna never be fucking with me, period. If I had him, you gonna know I had him. And you can't change his mind, period. Because then they're gonna always fuck with me regardless, like. And I guess bitches be so fucking, like, I hate that cocky asshole. I'm a fucker nigga. Listen, by all means, fuck him. But he gonna dog your ass. He gonna dog you so bad, bitch. He gonna fucking dog you. Because I'm like, I'm a homie, lover, friend type female. So, the nigga would tell me before you would even tell me. You get what I'm saying? And 9 times out of 10, I probably stunt him to you, bitch. Oh, I had bitches pay for my bundles. I had bitches pay for my little getaway, put gas in my car. I had bitches doing all type of shit. Because that's what type of female. Like, bitches be wanting to play dirty games. And thinking they're going to get over and play with me. And I act like I'm so mad. But girl, as soon as that nigga asks you for some money, you best believe that money coming to me. And it's a lot of hoes that done did it. Huh. Huh. So if they ever come for me, bitch, I always keep receipts. Period. So if a bitch ever come for me and she don't fuck the nigga I used to fuck with, 9 times out of 10, I hurt her little fucking feelings. Even if that nigga ain't asking for money. Oh, that nigga bought you something? Oh, he bought you something? Yeah, ho. He bought me this, he bought me that. Females now. He bought me this, he bought me that. I'm like, oh, okay. So that nigga, I need 2 of them. Oh, you have bought your girlfriend that. And I always say your girlfriend. To piss the nigga off. That ain't my motherfucking girlfriend, this, that, and the third. And some niggas, I just left the shit alone. Because the girl ain't never did this shit to me. But it was some bitches that almost came close to me. Really trying their ass because they was swapping down our fucking their nigga and I wasn't. So they would come at me sideways. So I was like, bitch, you keep thinking I'm fucking your nigga, I'm gonna fuck him. But he told me before she even said some shit. And she probably wasn't even gonna tell me. It would have just been something under her belt. She wasn't expecting that nigga to tell me shit. And I had to tell him, like, bitches just want to say, oh, her nigga tried to talk to me. And these bitches be butt-ass ugly. Like, bitch, don't do me. Like, my pussy ain't good. Bitch. Because 9 times out of 10, you just got something that that nigga wants. So it ain't got to be nothing about your pussy good. Because, baby. You got to suit my own horn and anything. But, yeah. She was just, you know, trying to fuck with him and he told me about that shit. So, I was going to beat her ass and I told her brother I was going to beat her ass. And I ain't never seen that bitch no more. So, like, the night before he left to go to Atlanta, you know, I just was basically asking permission to just start, like, not really asking permission, but just letting him know, like, I'm just going to start fucking with other people, you know, because clearly he doing him, and I don't, you know what I'm saying, like, I felt like that was the right way in doing it, so it wouldn't be no surprises, and he ain't trying to act stupid. Yeah. He was like, man, he was blowed, but at the same time, he knew he was doing him, so he was like, he was like, you a good girl, man. And he was like, I know, like, I can't be dogging you, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just can't do it. I can't do that to you. And, you know, and you sitting here waiting for me and I'm just doing my own thing. So, like, we just both came into understanding, like, we gonna always have that bond. But we both, you know, gonna see other people. And he helped me realize, like, through that whole situation with me and him, like, he treated me, like, with the most respect. Excuse me. Like, the utmost respect. Like, he didn't play with me like how he played with some of them girls. Like, and I done seen him play. But he ain't did me like that. Like, he just, you know, was letting me know the real deal. And I can do nothing but love him from, you know, for that, because it's not a lot of guys that do that shit. Just let you know what it is up front. And that's why it lasted so long, because he would tell me, you know what I'm saying? Now, I had this one friend. She's like a family friend. She used to date, I mean, my cousin's first baby mama. And I think he tried to talk to her. And she told me that shit. And I always respected her, like, because she ain't had to do that shit. She ain't had to tell me that. So I always would have respect for her. And I ain't never mentioned it to him. I ain't never told him what she told me, you know, because I met up with him, like, about 8 months ago. And we went back to our old little way again. And child, I don't even know how. Because, child, that nigga. But we will always, yeah, I remember I'm from the hood, so that's how you crack blue crabs. I don't know if y'all ever had blue crabs. But some people come in your life as a lesson to teach you something. And he taught me a lot. He taught me to have patience. Because, I mean, when I say, like, y'all see how C Murder is, like, he just got that mindset, like, this man done did time before, but he ain't, I don't think he ever did time. But he was, like, real wise. and just like lay back. Now when you're in the club, it was just one time, with me, y'all. It was this one time, like Savannah was in the house, and I think the dude was performing, and the dude that I ended up talking to, because he ended up having like little situations going on, he was there with his homeboy. It's like God be letting you run across people. And then he ended up putting them in your life. Like, I swear, like, me and this boy was in the same room. It was me and his boy turn. And then he taught me another lesson with somebody else, too. But that's when I really started going on my spiritual journey, dealing with him. Because, like, with... the truck driver, like, I really had to find myself. So that's basically what I did, was like find myself. And learn myself first and foremost, because it wasn't a sad situation. Because I was like, damn, like, I really care about this man. But it was like, you know, you gotta let it go. Like, so, like, I was going on dates and shit, but I ain't had sex with none of the dudes like I was going on dates with. It really took me, like, 6 months to heal from that situation. Like, I was dating, but I wasn't having sex. Because I was, like, somehow waiting for him to come back, you know? And then, like, one day he was like, man, you're going to be my wife one day. And this, in the DMs, he was like, in my DM, he was like, it just kills me to see Nevaeh grow up. And I ain't even around. Like, it be bothering him, and it be bothering me too, because it's like I see his kids, and they growing up beautifully, and it's like, with me, I'm like, damn, you know what I'm saying, like, but he has a lot on his plate. He just had 2 twins, a girl and a boy. And they are so beautiful. So, so beautiful. And then he got his son and his daughter. And, you know, it's just... maybe in another lifetime. We'll get it right. I know y'all like this girl here. Cracking crass with her motherfucking tea. But yeah. And what I want to tell, like, ladies, on a real tip, like, it's going to take you time to get over somebody. And y'all have to understand, like, everybody is not meant to be in your life forever. You're going to have some people that's going to stay around. You're going to have some people that come in and out. And then you're going to have some people that's, like, going to be inconsistent. Those ones that's inconsistent, you're going to have to learn from. Period. You're going to have to learn. Because it's a lesson that they're teaching you. So, with him, he more so taught me how to let go. Because I was not used to letting go. I will always hold on to it. or I always put the person in the back seat. And with him, it taught me, you know, let it go. Like when we linked up, we could have worked things out again. I believe like we could have. But being that his kids are so young, I didn't want to go through that. So I removed myself. It wasn't him, like, you know what I'm saying? It was never him saying, like, it was more so me. Like, because I wasn't going to allow, because I'm selfish, I want a person to myself. So, I knew he had younger kids, and it's like, you know, the baby mama gonna always be in that picture for at least till the child get up in age. I say, I don't know, like, if his kid's like 10, 12, you know what I'm saying? Like, or 13, 14, 15. I can give it a try because I'm like, okay, he, you know, the baby mama and him, they done got past all of that. And sometimes it don't be like that. But for the kids to be so young, I had to let it go. So, y'all, that's the end of my story time. And make sure y'all subscribe. And shout out to the 14 subscribers that I have. Y'all, we on 14. We going to speak it into existence. Make sure you subscribe. And hopefully, we'll get them subscribers up to 100K. You know, speak things to existence. All right, and I love y'all, and y'all have a good night.